Morning students, we'll begin with module number 4, syntax analysis. So this is what the second phase of compiler. So in the previous module we discussed about the tokens, fine, lexical analysis. So the first phase of the compiler exactly, fine. So we'll move on to the second phase, that is lexical analysis. In brief, see, in lexical analysis, the source program, whatever we get, so the string, streams of string, whatever we have in case of input or the statement, so that will be considered as a lexem. We are going to group them into a stream called as a lexem. For each and every individual lexem, we are having a predefined pattern to identify what kind of token it is, whether it is an identifier, whether it is a keyword, whether it is a number or else expression, okay, such kind. So according to that, what you used to do, your lexical analyzer will generate the series of token, okay, and also it will be simultaneously updating the symbol table also, okay. Now these two information, when we are receiving in the syntax analyzer, okay, using these token or else using this name particular, okay, we need to construct the parse tree over there. Okay, finally, from that parse tree, we are extracting the intermediate grammar over there. Okay, grammar to next, further, it will be continued exactly. Fine. So we'll begin the discussion of syntax analysis over there. So in the introduction part, we have what exactly parser or syntax analysis is. Okay, for lexical analysis, we have another name called as scanner. Okay, but here we have another name called as parser exactly. Okay, fine. Parser or syntax analysis basically check for the syntax of the language. Okay, next, a parser or a syntax analysis is a process which takes the inputs as tokens and produces either parse tree, syntactic structure, or generates error report over there. So this syntax analysis name only indicates, fine, we are checking the syntax of the source program. Okay, fine, the token, whatever we are generating, okay, let it be, let's keep it aside, okay. Now we'll concentrate what exactly the syntax of the source program should be, okay. If you are missing some semicolon, if you are missing some brackets, okay, undefined variable, okay, many different errors we are going to get based on the what syntax exactly, right? Okay, for one particular program or one particular program language, there will be a proper syntax, okay, without using a header file, without using a variables, okay, without initializing the variables and all, okay, we cannot go for writing a program over there, fine. These kind of errors can be identified in this particular phase over there. Clear? Okay, so that is what the job of the parser is. Okay, so here we got a figure, okay, which explains the role of the parser. Okay, see the intermediate one, the center square symbol what we have, okay, that is the parser exactly. So the previous is lexical analyzer and the next will be rest of front ends. Okay, total 6 different phases we have, right? Okay, so after the parser, okay, there will be different phases available, but generally we are considering it as what? Rest of front end we are considering it as. Okay, see, as we discussed this figure earlier, okay, but for a lexical analyzer it was. Now we'll go for how this figure will be explaining the parser exactly. Okay, source program will be the input for lexical analyzer. So what will be the output? Okay, it used to generate the tokens. Okay, but just remember, okay, from the previous module as we were discussing, okay, whenever there is a request for the token from the parser, then only your lexical analyzer will convert the source program into a token. Remember this. Okay, because of this, what we have, a bi-directional communication between lexical analyzer and parser we are having. Okay, see, lexical analyzer, if it is transferring a token, after receiving that, there should be a command from parser to the lexical analyzer that get next token. Okay, instead, if you are not getting any such kind of message, okay, like get next token for the lexical analyzer, it won't generate the token exactly. Okay, it won't read the lexem also. Remember this. Okay, there will be a strong communication between lexical analyzer and the parser. Okay, so what will be the output of this parser? Parse tree will be generated. Okay, so there will be a root. From that root, okay, we are going for leaf, then leaf to again leaf. Okay, such kind. Okay, parse tree will be generated for what purpose? To identify whether any errors are available or what. Clear? So this is what the role of parser is. Okay, so in this there is some small explanation, okay, regarding, like, instead of if you are not sending a command called as get next token, we won't be able to generate the tokens over there. Okay, and at last, if there is a, there are two possibilities of output. One is what the parser, and one is what the error exactly. That is what the possible outputs of a parser. One is what the parser can be generated if syntax is proper, otherwise error message should be generated. Remember this. Okay, so these are the two possible outputs what we can get for parse tree over there. Okay, next we'll go for, there are different types of parsers available for a grammar. Okay, there are universal parser we have, then top-down parser we have, and bottom-up parser we are having. Total three different parsers are available. Okay, so this universal parser, okay, which can pass any kind of a input, okay, but practically if you want to implement this, it is not possible exactly. Okay, means for our purpose, for generating the parse tree and for processing the source program, it is not possible. Okay, so the universal parse tree, okay, is using a CYK algorithm. It's an earliest algorithm, can pass any grammar over there. Okay, so but it is not efficient. Okay, inefficient we call it as for production of compiler exactly. Okay, it can pass any kind of a language. If it is having any error also, it won't identify or it will not let the user to know. Okay, so this universal parser is it can process any kind of a grammar, but we will not be using this for generating or creating a compiler exactly. So we are using rest of the two parsers available over here. One is what the top down parser. Okay, top down method build parse tree from the top. Okay, that is what the root to the bottom. Okay, that will be the leaves exactly. The example of this top down parser will be LL parser exactly. Okay, then bottom up parser, bottom up methods start from the leaves and work their way up to the root. In either case, the input of the parser is scanned from left to right. Okay, one symbol at a time exactly. The example for this bottom-up parser will be LR parser. Remember, whenever we are reading anything, okay, from the parse tree, okay, it should be read from left to right. Remember, left one should be read first. Okay, in the bottom, in the least, or else the last leaf, whatever we have, from that we need to read the left one first, then we need to go for right. Then again, next level, again left one, again right one. Okay, like that we need to read in case of both top-down parser and the bottom-up parser exactly. So the next subtopic will be syntax error handling. Okay, so we'll go through this. What are the different types of errors are available? If you are able to process only a correct programming language, okay, that whatever the user is going to write, then the design of this parser and the design of this compiler will be so simple. Okay, but here we need to observe the starting point, okay, of the program to the end point. Okay, so that will be a bit complex exactly. Okay, the common programming errors can occur at many different levels. Okay, so we'll see that. What are the different levels? So here they had mentioned total four different levels. One is what, lexical error. Second one is what, syntactic error, semantic error, and logical errors exactly. Okay, so these are the different levels. Okay, so we are considering it as different types of errors also, but these are the what, different levels where exactly error may occur over there. Okay, in case of a lexical error, it includes misspelling of identifier keywords or operators. Okay, whatever the keyword operator or else the identifiers we are using, if you are making any mistake, okay, while writing the spelling of that, okay, then it will be considered as a lexical error exactly. Okay, so that will be identified in the lexical analysis space itself. Okay, see here we have an example of identifier called as a Arun Kumar, ARUNKUMAR it should be. Okay, but here we are writing it as, instead of that we are writing instead of Arun Kumar original spelling, we are writing it as KMAR exactly. Sometimes we are writing KUMAR in our program. Okay, somewhere if you are writing it as KMAR, okay, that will be identified by lexical error exactly. Okay, and missing of quotes surrounding a string, okay, if that is what the case, that also can be identified by lexical analysis phase over there, or else we are considering it as a lexical error exactly, first type of error, okay, which may occur in our program exactly. Later, syntactic error. Okay, so this will be syntax kind of error. Okay, missing of brackets, obvious. Okay, missing of semicolons, okay, if anything is up here. Okay, then case statement without enclosure of switch. Okay, so this will be also considered as syntactic error over there. Okay, like the gesture. Okay, based on the gesture, what we can identify the error. Okay, that will be under syntactic error exactly. Then semantic error we are having. Semantic always represents the type of the information, type of the operand, whatever we have. So if you are declaring it as integer and if you are using a floating point number, okay, such kind of errors, okay, maybe identified by your syntactic errors exactly. Okay, so includes type mismatch between operators and operands exactly. That can be identified by syntactic errors exactly. Then later, logical errors we are having. Okay, so instead of equals, if you are using equal to equal to comparison operator, then these are the consideration of logical errors exactly. Okay, so these are the few different levels of error which we may face in our programming exactly. Okay, then we got some goals over here for error handling. Okay, the error handling in a parser has goals that are simple to state but challenging to realize exactly. Okay, the first one we have, report the presence of error clearly and accurately. Okay, so where exactly the error is available, what kind of error is available, okay, that should be identified by a parser and it should be reported over there. This is what the first goal. Okay, line number, yes, it is possible by using a lexical analyzer. We can trace where exactly on what particular line we have an error. Clear? Okay, by using the lexical analyzer we have a communication between lexical analyzer and a parser. Okay, so they can identify the line number and what kind of error it is, that will be analyzed by your syntactic analyzer. Okay, later, recover from each error quickly enough to detect subsequent errors exactly. Okay, so if you're finding one error, okay, it should be in a position like it should be analyzed properly, and we need to go for identifying the next error over there. Okay, we should not waste the time for only one error. We need to identify the whole program errors exactly. Sometimes, like initially when we compile, we'll be having 10 errors. Okay, when we start debugging the program, okay, then error may increase over there. Okay, because of what? Okay, in some situation, okay, a few errors are hidden from the compiler over there. Okay, so when, like, while declaring, we may be making some mistake over there. Okay, some kind of mistakes will be there in the initial part of the program over there. Okay, because of that, some errors will be masked while compilation. Okay, so that should be handled quickly exactly. Okay, then add minimum overhead to the processing of correct program. Okay, so these are the few goals of what exactly our error handler. So the next subtopic is error recovery strategies. Now these are defined like 4 to 5 different error levels where we can identify different types of errors over there. Okay, then whenever we find such kind of error, what will be the recovery strategy that also we need to opt over here. Okay, the following activities are performed whenever error are detected by parser. Okay, the first one will be detected this syntax error accordingly, and produces appropriate error message so that the programmer can correct the program over there. Okay, so whenever we are identifying any error, that should be intimated for the user or else a programmer, okay, so that he can correct it properly. Okay, see, some minor mistakes, if it is available, okay, that can be overcome by the compiler. Okay, so the warning and all, whatever we get, okay, so that can be overcome. Like, finally, the program will be executed, okay, instead of after having different warnings also, it will allow the program to execute. Okay, how? By, because of some minor corrections over there. But if it is a major, that should be considered as a error, and we need to correct it. Okay, user need to correct it. Okay, so whatever the error we get, okay, that should be intimated for the user over there. Okay, it has to recover from the error quickly and detect subsequent error in the program over there. So the second point will be the recovery strategy. Second recovery strategy will be what? Okay, whatever the error we are going to get, okay, that should be identified properly. Okay, and we need to go for identifying the next errors exactly. Okay, and this error recovery strategy should not make the compiler to slow down its compilation. Okay, so that should be also the strategy we need to opt for the error handling over there. Then here we are having different error recovery methods available over here. Okay, first one we call it as panic mode recovery. Okay, so it is the simplest and most popular error recovery method. Okay, when error is detected, the parser discards symbol one at a time, okay, until next synchronizing token, means valid token, is found. Okay, so example, okay, I want to take an example, like instead of writing a keyword called as if, okay, double if I am writing, okay, then here there is a mismatch, right? The pattern of a keyword called as what? If, but here we have double if over here. Now this should be deleted exactly. Which should be deleted? See here, first one we have, okay, fine, that will be red. Second I, what we have, this should be deleted exactly. Okay, then F should be considered. Then we are getting a complete keyword called as if exactly. So this is what the panic mode recovery is. Okay, whatever you feel unnecessary, okay, like when you are comparing the input with the pattern which is already available for that particular token, okay, if there is a mismatch, then we need to go for deleting some aspect, or we need to add some aspect over there. Okay, it is not compulsory like panic mode recovery will only delete the content. Okay, no, okay, it will also add some content. So okay, fine, so here we got one example. Just see here, this is an input expression, okay, like bracket open x plus y into sign like star star z close bracket plus k exactly. Okay, so the parser scans the input from left to right and finds no error after reading bracket open x comma plus comma y comma star, first star. Okay, but after reading the second star, okay, it's it knows that no expression has consecutive or else we'll be not having, okay, double star is not allowed exactly. Okay, so that extra star should be the error in this particular expression. So what we need to do, we need to skip that particular extra star and we need to start going for finding the next proper token or else synchronizing token, what we call. Okay, so consecutive star, whatever we have, like multiple number of consecutive stars if we are having. In this example, we are taking only two, right? Okay, see here, if you are having total three different consecutive stars available, okay, x plus y star 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 z, okay, so after reading one star, yes, it is allowed. Then later second, no, it is not allowed exactly, it will skip. Okay, then later again it will skip the third one, okay, until it find a valid token. Z is a valid token, yes, obvious. Okay, there may be a declaration of z in the initial part of the program, okay, maybe anything. Okay, so z we are considering it as what, a valid token exactly. So until it find the next valid token, it will start skipping everything whatever lies between this, okay, between the two valid input, okay, or between the two valid tokens, whatever the invalid pattern we are going to get, okay, everything will be skipped over there. Okay, this is what the panic mode recovery is. Okay, then later phase level recovery we are having, the next one. Okay, it is also a bit simple. Okay, on discovering an error, a parser may perform local correction on a remaining input. Okay, that is, it may replace a prefix of a remaining input by some strings that allows the parser to continue. Okay, so whenever we find such kind of errors, okay, your compiler will try to replace something. Okay, so here it won't replace much. Okay, some local replace we are considering it as. Okay, so that it can bring that mismatch, okay, into a particular pattern over there. Okay, so here a typical local correction is, okay, so we'll see that what are those local correction to replace a comma by a semicolon. Okay, like in the end of as a terminator, we are using the semicolon instead of semicolon if you have a comma. Okay, sometimes it happens exactly. Okay, instead of comma we will be placing like instead of semicolon we will be placing colon over there. Okay, such kind. Okay, if that is available, it can be replaced by semicolon over there, or else extra semicolon if you are placing, like as a terminator double semicolon if you are placing, then one can be eliminated over there. Okay, so these are all things are coming under the phase level recovery, we call it as. Or else if there is no semicolon, okay, then that can be placed. Okay, but usually in C program, okay, it will be created as an error that we don't have a terminator. Terminator is very important, remember. Okay, so then disadvantages are very difficult to implement. Okay, slow down the passing of correct program. Okay, proper care must be taken while choosing replacement as they may lead to infinite loops over there. Okay, so instead of blindly inserting or blindly deleting some symbols over there, okay, so it should be like it should not allow us to enter an infinite loop over there. So these are the different disadvantages what we have in the phase level recovery over there, like the error production. Okay, so this is what a error message what we are generating. Okay, like what type of error it is. Okay, error production is a concept, okay, we are using which will allow or which will help us to identify what kind of error it is. See here, they are mentioned one example. When we implement the parser, okay, when an error production is used, okay, it displays the appropriate error message over there. Okay, what kind of error it is, it will be identified. For example, okay, consider the expression 10x. Okay, mathematically it means multiply 10 with x, but in programming language it should be written like 10 star exactly. Such error can be identified very easily by error production exactly. So this type of error can be identified by error production phase over there. Okay, so these are the different strategies what we can use over here. Okay, then later global correction. So here we are using one algorithm, we call it, or else a method, we call it as least cost correction method. The global correction method replaces an incorrect input with the correct input using least cost correction method exactly. Okay, so we are not implementing this again, it is a theoretical interest. Okay, so what it used to perform is, see, you will be expecting, or your program will be expecting a string pattern called as a Why? Input string pattern. Observe my words. Input string pattern, your program is expecting in a pattern of y exactly. But you are entering in a pattern called as x. Okay. So now using this least correction method, okay, what we need to do? We need to bring that x format into y format over there. How? Using the parse tree. Okay, we need to eliminate some aspect, we need to insert some aspect, okay, so that like it will not be a total change. Remember, okay, if the input inputted expression or inputted data should be like three character followed by one digit, again three character, okay, instead of that you may be having a four character followed by two digits and four character for again it will be followed, okay, such kind of inputs may be available. Okay, so these kind of inputs can be brought into a proper format so that we should generate the output properly. Okay, so these are the few strategies, okay, and different kinds of error whatever we may face while dealing with the syntax analysis phases over there. Okay, so in the next session we'll go for the context-free grammar.